Welcome to this next lesson. And what I want to do in this lesson is to discuss another scenario where we would use a self-join. And so let's get started with that. So I went ahead and I created a database named Week 6. So I assume you will do the same to follow along with this video. And so let's begin. Okay, so let's assume I have this one table, right? This employee table. It has a ID as the primary key. It has a first name. It has a last name, and it has a manager ID. So what does this mean? Well, I will go ahead and I will load this database. Okay, and then we will discuss a bit. Okay, so I will select all from employee. Or is it employees? No. Spelling is off. Okay. So I have an ID, I have the first name, the last name, and I have the manager ID. Notice that the manager ID for Jane Smith is empty, so it's null. And so notice that if you leave off the not null specifier, that means that the field, the column, can have missing values. In other words, can have null values. All right. So if you say not null, I have to always provide something. So in this case, manager ID can be empty. So I will say Jane Smith and then null to tell Postgres that it's empty. Okay. So I have the manager ID, which simply says that the one is actually the boss or the manager of this person. So if I look at it, Jill Sosa, her boss manager is Jane Smith. Likewise, Josh Sullivan, his boss is also Jane Smith. And Joseph Suggs, his boss is Jill Sosa. Okay. So Jane Smith does not have a boss, which means that she is the boss. She is the owner of the company. So if you're the owner, then you don't have a boss. And that's the reason why it is null. Now, notice that I had to visually inspect the table and then cross-reference to see who is whose boss. Now, like I keep saying, in a realistic situation, you will have some department, some company that has 10,000 employees. All right? And you wouldn't want to be checking one by one to find who's the boss of whom. So what we can do is to employ the idea of a self-join, where we will join this table employee with itself based on ID and manager ID as the joining force. And that way we'll be able to see for each employee the name of their boss. Okay, so let's try that. All right, so we're gonna do I'll write the code here. Okay, so here we will perform a self join to find for each employee their boss. slash manager. All right, so I'm just gonna say select, okay, and I'm gonna use E, okay, for employee. So I'm gonna say select E, that first name, okay, and I'm gonna change it to something that's meaningful. I'm gonna say this column will be called F name, okay, emp F name. And then I want E dot last name, and I'm gonna change that name to be emp L name, okay. And let's put a comma here. And then the next table, right? Since both of them are the employee table, I will call this one M for manager, okay? And so I would want to see M dot first name as boss F name. And then finally M dot last name, and I'm gonna rename it to boss L name. All right. Okay, so these are the columns that will be displayed. All right, so I will have employee first name, employee last name, and the manager first name, manager last name. And remember, this information is coming from the same table. All right, so I'm gonna say from, and I'm gonna say employee, and I'm gonna call this first table E, okay? And now I'm gonna do an inner join, okay? And I'm gonna inner join on employee again. Now, because we are joining the two same tables, we have to give each one a different name. So I'm gonna call this one M, okay? Now, we have to decide how we want to join. What is it that we want the DBMS to check? Okay, so if you look here, we basically want to see what this manager ID matches up to in terms of ID. Okay, so like we did when I see one, well, let's match up and see what one is. When I see two, well, let's match up and tell me what two is. So we're gonna be matching, we're gonna be joining on the manager ID and ID, right? So we will assume, right, in our minds, we have to realize that we will have two separate tables. So DBMS will call, let's say this first one, E. And then the DBMS will have another table, which it will call M. And so it will join them, and they'll be joined based on ID and manager ID. Okay, so it will basically be matching them. Just like how we do a regular join with two different tables. Okay, so all we have to do now is to say, let's start off with manager. Let's just call this one E. And let's call this one the manager ID. Okay. And if we have manager ID, right, then we want to match up the other one with the ID. Okay, so it will be, we'll have to call it M, right? M dot ID, okay? So ID from one of them and manager ID from the other one, right? So again, this simply means that we are comparing manager ID to ID. So let's give this a go. And there we see that Jill Sosa has a boss of Jane Smith. Josh Sullivan has the same boss. And Joseph Suggs has the manager, Jill Sosa. All right. Now, the Jane Smith is nowhere to be found, right? Because it's an inner join. And remember, with an inner join, the keys must be present in both tables. So, if we do, okay. So, because the Jane Smith did not have a manager ID, then Postgres simply did not include Jane Smith as an employee. Because if it had included Jane Smith, then the boss L name and boss F name would have been empty, right? Remember, that's inner join. But what if we want to actually show Jane Smith? Then you know that to do that, we would simply use a left outer join, because we know that it will show the employee, but since she does not have a boss, those will be null. So I'll just copy this. Alright. And I will simply specify that we don't want a inner join, we want a left outer join. Right, and so here we have every employee, right? The boss, of course, doesn't have a boss, so that's the reason why it is null for fname and for last name. Alright, so this is a common scenario where we do a self-join when the information that we want is in the same table. Okay, and so to get that information, we have to sort of imagine that it's two different tables. And so we will give them different names, and then we will say, okay, I want to join based on the ID, okay, and based on the manager ID. And so because they're the same table, obviously we have to give them different names. So that the DBMS knows how to proceed. So E that manager ID, if I compare those IDs to the same employee table based on ID, then what are their names? Okay. All right. So that's it for this short video. Again, we already looked at self-joins in the last lesson. And so this is just another example of how we would perform a self-join. It happens quite a lot where you have self-joins based on one table. Great. I'll see you in the next lesson where we will look at our other types of relationships dealing with tables and databases. I'll see you in that lesson.